So we've had a little series called Zen Friends and Fellow Travelers. I want to introduce you to a hermit, a genuine hermit, a man called John Ure, up in the north of Scotland. So it's August 2007. I've been walking on pilgrimage through the UK as best I can, following the central line of the island, just living on food that people gave me, not carrying any money. I'm arriving at the north tip of Scotland, which is a place called Cape Wrath. There's no direct access. You have to get a boat across and then walk probably about 12 miles or something like that on a tiny little coastal track. The summer of 2007 was very wet. I arrived in a kind of raging rainstorm. That was the finish point of my walk. Now, up there on the north tip of Scotland, there are no trees. There's a lot of wind. And if you park your car in the wrong direction, particularly in the winter, then the wind just takes the door off. It's pretty exposed. So I arrive at the Cape Wrath Lighthouse, which is the finish point. This lighthouse, remote from any human habitation, on the highest cliffs in Britain. I'm exhausted. I haven't really eaten properly for about the last 100 miles because there's very, very few people way up north. So it was hard to get anything to eat. So I'm soaking wet. You've got the lighthouse itself and then a few ancillary buildings around that look pretty wrecked. There was a kind of a ruined garage with a Land Rover that had had its door blown off. And so I got into this Land Rover and I was kind of dozing over the steering wheel as the rain kind of slowly eased off. I was kind of half awake, half asleep. Probably more asleep than awake, but vaguely conscious that the rain was easing down. In my kind of half dream state, I seem to have the impression of a dog bark, and then another one. And then suddenly there are these spaniels jumping all over me, licking my hands and grabbing me and so on. So of course I'm awake now. So I get out of the Land Rover. There's a human. I'm not expecting another person for really the last 20, 25 miles of the walk, probably. It's somebody called John Ure, who's a hermit who lives in the old lighthouseman's cottage, right at the base of the Cape Wrath Lighthouse, the only human being for miles and miles, literally no road even to his place. So, John was tremendously welcoming, as were his spaniels. In the lighthouseman's cottage, he had a big pile of tins in one corner, which was the food that he lived on, a big pile of tins in another corner, which was what the spaniels lived on. And there he is. He's out there. He's still out there now. I've met him up there subsequently once or twice. So if you ever get the chance to get out to Cape Wrath, John's creating a kind of a cafe. And, you know, as a way to make a little bit of a living. As you can imagine, things are pretty precarious out there. Now, to give you a little sense of how precarious things are, maybe 3 winters ago, his wife, who lives in the nearest village, had made him a Christmas lunch and gone down to the boat landing to get the boat across to travel up their last few miles to Cape Wrath. It was too rough. She couldn't get across. She comes down the next day, getting closer to Christmas all the time, with everything all packed up. Still no good. This went on day after day after day. Conditions were just too rough to get across. So then, I think it was sometime into January before she was able to get across and meet John, and the local newspaper ran a story about the last man in Britain to get his Christmas lunch. This got picked up by one of the national newspapers. They ran the story too. And sometime into February, John had a kind of a knock on the lighthouseman's door there. Somebody from Hollywood. We want to sign the rights of this story. The last man in Britain to get their Sunday lunch. And basically signed him enough of a check that he was able to carry on living up there for a couple more years. So that's kind of how hand-to-mouth hermit life is right up in the north of Scotland. Go and meet John if you get the chance. He's somebody who's in the right place. He's about as isolated as you can get on the mainland of Britain, but he's a happy man. Mark, who works with me here at Zenways, he's come up and met him too, and one or two other people know him as well. John Ure, he's a Zen friend or fellow traveller, well worth meeting. How can Zenways help you? Five ways. Number one, subscribe and hit the notification bell here on our YouTube channel. We've got new videos every week. Number two, get a hold of a copy of Practical Zen. This is our main practice manual, particularly building a foundation around 100 days of continuous practice in our style. Number three, you can become a Zenways member. It's free, it's all based on donations. We have a thriving worldwide community of practitioners, activities and events, both online and live. Number four, we have a series of retreats. Particularly, I'd like to recommend our Breakthrough to Zen retreats. Again, all based on donations, no charge. Again, online and live, and very much geared towards helping you get your first step in the world of enlightenment. And then number five, if you're interested in doing an externally validated professional training with us, you can become a meditation and mindfulness teacher, and you can become a yoga teacher. All the information on zenways.org.